Jesus, I demand you. Mr. Grinch, you really are a hero. You're as cuddly as a cactus, as charming as an
eel. Mr. Grinch,
you're a bad banana with a greasy black beard. And a monster, Mr. Grinch. Your heart's an empty hole. Your brain is full of spiders. You got garlic in your soul,
Mr. Grinch.
I wouldn't touch you with a 39.5-foot pole.
Mr. Grinch, you have termites in your smile. You have all the tender sweetness of a seasick crocodile,
Mr. Grinch.
Given the choice between the two of you, I take the seasick crocodile.
Then he slid down the chimney, a rather tight pinch. But if Santa could do it, then so could the Grinch. He got stuck only once for a moment or two. Then he stuck his head out of the fireplace blue, where the little hoo-hoo stockings all hung in a row. These stockings, he Grinched, are the first things to go. Then he slithered and slumped with a smile most unpleasant around the whole room, and he took every present. And he stuffed them in bags. Then the Grinch, very nimbly, stuffed all the bags up the chimney. Then he slunk to the icebox. He took the moose feast. He took the moo pudding. He took the roast beast. He cleaned out that icebox as quick as a flash. Why, that Grinch even took their last can of poo hash. Then he stuffed all the food up the chimney with glee. And now, friend the Grinch, I will step up the tree.
You're a vile
Mr.
Grinch. Your heart is full of unwashed thoughts. Your soul is full of
gum. Mr. Grinch.
The three words that best describe you are as follows, and I quote: stink,
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 stink, stink.
You're the one, Mr. Grinch.
Good afternoon, everybody. Hope you've enjoyed our first act of Holiday Spectacular 2018. I'm Chris Grayson, Performing Arts Department Chairman. Welcome to the L.A. Graham Auditorium. We've got a wonderful another half of the show for you this afternoon. If we've got any other children, make their way up here and listen to one of my favorite Christmas stories, one that I've read to my kids every year. I'm really excited to be able to share this with everybody here. Before Christmas, when all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas would soon be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads, and Mama in her kerchief, and I in my cap, had just settled down for a long winter's nap. When out on the lawn, there arose such a clatter. I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window, I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters, and threw up the sash.
For happy than eagles, his course is in.
suffers at the grocery store today. He was standing at the front door giving candy canes away. And I told him I was worried about one certain situation. How Santa's gonna get here with this rising population.
Single word as you hear, and he said, "My sins are decided.
Yeah.
Thank you.
yuletide carols being sung by a choir and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. Ooh,
they know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh.
Every mother's child
to 92.